Hi guys, it's me, your teacher Belle, and welcome to my channel. For this video, I will discuss the definition of financial management. Ano nga ba si financial management? When we say financial management, it covers the planning, organizing, leading, and controlling of all financial activities of an organization. Also, it puts emphasis on managing the funds of an organization, which includes day-to-day operations, investment decisions, and financing those investments. For the first part of the definition of financial management, na-mention doon yung apat na functions ni management. Sila planning, organizing, leading, and controlling. Which I know, hindi na bago sa inyo. Kasi nga, I'm sure na na-discuss na ito sa inyo nung organization and management ninyo. Itong apat na functions ni management. But for this discussion, we will discuss these four in the point of view of financial management. Let's have the first function, si planning. Ano nga bang meron kay planning? When we say planning, it is the task of determining how a business will afford to achieve its strategic goals and objectives. After establishing these goals and objectives of the business class, dito na papasok si planning. Si finance, which holds the responsibility in managing the funds of the business, it will create a plan where this plan contains the necessary activities that should be done to achieve these goals and objectives, as well as the resources that will be used to carry out those activities. And this plan nga class is called the budget. So, nasa budget lahat ng activities na kinakailangan to achieve these goals and objectives of the company. As well as the resources, especially yung amount na gagamitin to buy or purchase those resources. Kasi nga needed tong resources to carry out those planned activities. At si finance class, siya yung gumagawa ng master budget. When we say master budget, nandito na lahat ng budget ng each department. Kasi nga, each department class will create their budget. Siyempre, sila yung nakakaalam kung ano yung mga needed nila. Then, after they created their budget, ibibigay nila to sa finance. Then, si finance na yung bahala na mag-compile ng lahat ng budget ng each department. And that compilation is the master budget na nga. Sa tingin ninyo class, bakit mahalaga si planning in managing the funds of the organization? Kasi nga class, kung wala si planning, kung walang plan or budget yung each department, hindi magiging maayos yung distribution or allocation ng funds. Parang si planning, siya yung guide sa allocation ng funds. Siya yung susundin para yung distribution ng funds is sakto lang. Kung ano lang yung kailangan ng department. Walang labis, walang kulang. And then, makakapaghanda pa si finance. Kasi nga, kung nasa kanya na yung budget, then alam na ni finance kung magkano yung kakailanganin ng each department. Now, let's go to organizing. Ano naman ang meron sa organizing? In organizing, it involves coordinating and allocating a firm's resources. And those resources class is yung money na nga or yung funds ni business in order to carry out its plans. This time, ito na yung i-distribute na, i-allocate na or ibibigay na ni finance department yung allotted amount dun sa budget. Kung ano yung nakalagay sa budget, yun yung ibibigay ni finance department. That fund is given to the department so that it may carry out its planned activities na. Kasi nga, hindi naman ma-approve yung budget ng department kung hindi nakita ni top management na needed ito to achieve the goals and objectives of the company. Kailangan may approval muna ng top management or yung may-ari nga ng business yung budget ng department before i-release ni finance yung amount or yung money. Now let's go to the next function, leading. Ano naman ang meron sa leading? Leading class ensures that planned service outcomes are actually achieved. Si finance class, hindi natatapos yung kanyang responsibility sa pagbibigay ng funds sa department. It is also the responsibility of this department, the finance department, to manage the other departments. To ensure that, yun nga, isinakatuparan or isinagawa nito yung activities na nakalagay doon sa budget nila. Kasi nga, syempre, naka-release na nung funds eh. Nasa department na yung funds. Di ibig sabihin, wala nang hadlang para hindi nila maisagawa yung planned activities nila. Kaya, it is the responsibility of the finance department to check kung kumikilos nga ba yung department na yun. And lastly, we have controlling. Ano naman ang meron sa controlling? Controlling class, it is the regular monitoring of expenditure. Bakit kailangan regular or laging minomonitor yung expenses ng company? It is to verify expenditure against target. Kung yung nagastos nga ba ng each department is according to their budget. And to identify changing patterns or circumstances that need corrective action. This time, kung yung department na yon is gumawa nga ng budget, pero hindi nila sinunod yung budget. Especially kung mas malaki yung budget nila, pero yung nagastos nila is konti lang. It means may sobra pa dun sa budget nila. Okay lang naman yun kung may sobra. Pero kung sinadya talaga, let's just say that department is planning to commit a fraud. Bali dadayain nung department si business. That's why si finance, kaya always ditong minomonitor yung naggastos ng each department para maiwasan yung mga ganong sitwasyon kung saan mandadaya na yung department. Dadayain na yung business. And those are the functions of financial management class. Now let's go to the second part of the definition, where financial management puts emphasis on managing the funds of an organization. And these funds include day-to-day operations or yung operating activity, investment decisions, investing activity, and financing those investments or yung financing activity. Now let's discuss the three activity or the three classifications of cash flows, which I know familiar na din kayo, but sige, let's discuss it again. For the first one, we have operating activity. In operating activity class, it indicates the amount of money a company brings in from its ongoing regular business activities. To yung cash flow class, when we say cash flow, ito yung pumasok at lumabas na pera sa business. So the cash flow in the operating activity came from the regular business activities. For example, yung pera na nanggaling sa income. Yan, regular activity yan. As well as yung lumabas na pera para pambayad ng expenses. Regular activity yan. Now let's go to investing activity. Ano naman ang meron sa investing activity? In investing activity, it involves purchase and sale of long-term assets. Ang cash flow naman dito class sa investing activity is yung pera na ginamit sa pagbili at yung pera na nakuha sa pagbenta ng mga long-term assets or yung non-current assets. And these non-current assets class are the equipments, vehicles, and other properties of the business na may long-term use. or pangmatagalan yung paggamit dito ng business. Lastly, we have cash flow from financing activity. Ano naman yung cash flow dito sa financing activity? The flow of cash of this classification class came from the owners. Yan yung investments ni owners. That is a financing activity. As well as yung nautang ni business from its creditors. Pero that liability class is a long-term one. Bali, babayaran yan ni business ng mahabang panahon. Or more than 1 year. Okay, so we have reached the end of the document. So that will be all for this discussion class. I hope you learned something from this video. But still, thank you for listening and see you on our next discussion. I will...